Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari. We're finally done with the Black Pits. I missed all these guys so much. I'm really excited to be back to the main quest.
I don't want to talk.
Then I will talk and get back to the characters we love and back to the storyline. We gotta go help Duke Eltan. And after that, I guess we're going to the Iron Throne? No, the Ducal Palace. Tamoko, right? A mysterious woman named Tamoko has told me that Duke Eltan's healer is not to be trusted. It is likely the cause of Eltan's sickness. She also spoke of me in a strange manner. She knows more than she is saying. I shall have to seek her out in the future. She said that she will be near the Flaming Fist headquarters if I wish to speak with her again. Alright, so we're going to do that first. I mean, by all rights, this Duke Eltan should be way dead by now. Like, oh yeah, we buried him and he actually is partially decomposed at this point, at least. He'll probably be alive. he's a tough guy. Saravak has assumed command of the Iron Throne. I am still accused of the former leader's murders, though it is thought I was an agent of Am. Someone is intent upon pushing the region into war. Yeah. Tensions are growing in the region due to the supposed threat from Am, though the evidence I've seen is somewhat confused. Yeah, it's not Am, it's Saravak. And it's not us, it's Saravak. Now this was the werewolf island. Is this the latest? Yeah, the Harper Delthier says that the Iron Throne is ready to seize power in Baldur's Gate. He suggests we infiltrate the Iron Throne's citadel to search for evidence of their schemes. But we've been all through there. Is there gonna be anything new there? And then also, important events. Alright. Upon entering the Undercellar, I was accosted by the assassins Slythe and Kristen, associates of Saravak. Among several important documents on their bodies was an invitation to the Ducal Palace, my next destination. So I don't know if I'm going to be going through the Iron Throne Citadel. Well, headquarters, isn't it? I think it's called headquarters. Like when you get up to the place. I don't think I'm going to be going through there again, but we might have something, actually. It's been so long. It's been just so long. Yeah, probably this is what we're looking for. Sly, the time to strike is now. I'm just reminding me and at the same time you guys, in case you might need to be reminded of what's going on. When the party commences on the night of my coronation, you will join up with my doppelganger assassins at the sewer entrance to the palace. You are to insinuate yourself into the crowd in the ballroom. When I have finished my speech, you will strike. If you aren't there, my doppelgangers will proceed without you. Oh, yeah. We took care of them, so like, doppelgangers, I guess we'll try to proceed without them. And your payment will be forfeit. Make sure to keep a leash on your little bitch of a wife. Oh, nice. An invitation to the party is included with this note, Saravak. I think we've already copied it, but I'll do it again. This is an invitation to the inauguration of the newest Grand Duke of Baldur's Gate. It will be held at the Ducal Palace. Present this invitation to the guard at the gate, and you'll be allowed entrance. Again, just in case. Alright, so I have these. Potions of Invisibility. I have like three more of them, in case we need any more. What I'm going to do is I'm going to get close. I'm going to use the Potions of Invisibility. According to this, all we do is not go in combat and it lasts for 12 hours. So hopefully that's long enough. Hopefully we'll be able to open doors and things like that. That's another invisibility spell where you can't open doors or, like, interact with things, I believe. I think that's the second level one they mentioned. That's detect invisibility. The caster cannot perform any actions that manipulate the environment around her, such as opening doors, disarming a trap, or opening a chest. The caster can, however, cast defensive spells on herself and fellow party members, and if she attacks, she immediately becomes visible. The invisibility enables her to attack first. So it says it's a version of that spell. Similar. So hopefully we can open doors and stuff, because we might have to open a few doors. So I don't want to be killing flaming fist people.
Go pester someone else.
So we're gonna get closer, because it lasts for 12 hours.
Sure.
Now the other spell lasts for 24 hours, but you can't open doors and such. Actually, got an idea. Well, let's get here.
Sure.
A day and a half to get over here. Good thing the guards around here don't care. We really don't need anything around here, just gonna set some spells, rest, and move on.
Alright.
We must rest. Let that case of hunger change fools.
Yeah, we literally came here pretty much just to rest. So surprised. Second level spells, you can only know three of them. Knock, mirror image, and resist fear. Is that one creature? Okay. So I figured we could cast it on like four of us, and then the other two can take the potion. If I have it right, they can take the potion and they can open the doors, and the rest of us will just, that are under the spell, will just follow around and not interact with anything. Hopefully I don't mess that up. I think what is this? This is a right. She can't cast enchantment. Oh, she doesn't actually have the spell. All right, so I can only cast it on three people. But that's good, because if the 12 hours run out, I got more potions for people. Plus we need to get our spells replenished as it is. So it's illusion, right? Illusion, phantasm, and I forget what she can't cast. I thought it was enchantment. I was right. Okay. She just doesn't know the spell. Let me just check something. Make sure I don't have one sitting around in here. Nope. I kind of doubt he's selling any.
My inn is open to all who behave themselves.
You don't sell scrolls, do you? Probably just the ones that we sold you. Yeah, apparently invisibility scrolls are not that common, or we just sold them all to somebody else. Alright. We don't have anything to identify, do we? I don't think we need these. I'll just hold on to them for now, I guess. That's Master Thievery. Yeah, we don't need anything. Alright. Let us rest.
I'm tired.
It's been dreadful slow business lately.
Well, here's some business. Alright. Obviously I'm not...
I need an ale.
Too late for ale. We're leaving.
Alright.
So the question is, how close do we get? Can we go up to the bridge and not be spotted? I think there are no guards around the immediate entrance of, well, the zone. Not the city, I mean. We'll save. If I wanted to, I could go here to be safe, but, or even here is, looks closer, but.
All right.
Okay, it looks like we're in luck.
What?
So. Invisibility. It's pretty loud, invisibility. Alright, the caster types. Two for you. Two for you. She can have the rest. And I do have three more in a her potion bag. Alright, so we should be invisible.
Alright. Go pester someone else.
Doesn't say we're invisible. Non-detectable, but that's because of what she's wearing. Hide in shadows, maybe that. Or this. Alright, let's hope everything works out.
Alright. I need it. Alright.
So it's quicker to just go like this. And I think what we want is here. Flaming Fist Castle, right? That's where we meet her. Alright, let's go.
Why me?
We look invisible, except for me. Oh, because I cast a spell again after that. After I cast it on myself, I cast a spell. Okay, I can't... I messed that up. I knew I was going to mess it up somehow. The fact that it doesn't show us is...
Yes?
It should say invisible here, shouldn't it? Alright. Surprised it wouldn't say that.
Why me?
We're invisible, you can't see us. Flaming Fist Headquarters. Tamoko. Let's not get too close. Where is Tamoko? Not reacting so far. Well, that's Tamoko. Once we talk to her, the visibility is going to wear off. What's the problem?
Go pester someone else.
So, see, he drank the potion so he can interact, right?
Why me?
I must talk to you in private. These are troubled times.
I see you have sought me out, as I thought you would. I have things that must be said, things that are important to us both. I have but one condition to my discourse, and you must agree before I speak. A promise I seek, and I will accept no less. You have said many interesting things, but I do not trust you. Why should I make promises for information unheard? My promise will not harm you, though ignoring it can. Indeed, my information can only benefit. You will gain if you did not know it before, and you will gain if you knew it but needed it confirmed. The choice I pose is the only option. Are you in agreement or not? I shall offer my promise, then, and follow it as best as I can. Thank you. Here's my request. Though it may seem quite odd, I charge you to defeat Saravok, the man behind all your woes. You must destroy his plans and stop his scheme in its tracks. You must strip him of the belief that he can succeed in this path he follows. You must do this for me, and you must also leave him his life. I will help him to live his life as a man, not as the god he thinks it can be. I do not see how such a thing is possible. He has sought to destroy me, and I have only responded in kind. Saravok seeks to destroy everyone, not just you. You are of particular interest because of your shared origins with him. You are a possible rival, one of the few that are worthy of his personal attention. Above all else, you are family. I see this as startling news, though likely you have suspected as much. Does this disturb you? It should not. Monsters are often closer to us than we like to think. You are siblings, and the paths open to him are yours as well, though he has been racing down his from his earliest days. You had Garion to guide you, did you not? Saravak had no one. He draws his strength from his hatred, from the thought of rising above those he knows to be inferior. His divine blood hungers for conquest, and that is why he must be defeated, but not killed. He deserves another, but does not know it. Alright, so we're both then children of Baal. His divine blood. He serves another. Did I say deserves? He serves another, but does not know it. Sorry, guys. Divine blood? He serves another? Of what do you speak? The child becomes the father, or desperately wishes so. The blood pulls, calls, and demands. The wise Alando did say unto the ages that the Lord of Murder would perish, and his doom would spawn his mortal progeny. Did say that. Chaos would be sown in their passage, but to what purpose? You have felt the hunger, and heard the offerings of power? Saravak thinks they are true, and so he seeks a senseless war, and a slaughter of a scale so grand as to defy description. He thinks it will launch him to what? Possibly he is right, but I cannot lose him to this. Why do you oppose him when you so clearly care for his life? Saravak is... I share Saravak's company, and would do so until I die, given the choice. That is all you need to know. I would save the man within the beast he wishes to be. I do not believe he will survive his plan. It is all based on conjecture, at best. He feels that he has been chosen, and that he will become more than he is. I do not share his belief. Gods are not known for bequeathing their powers, especially if they have foreseen their deaths. Whatever he is, I would keep him here, grounded firmly among those of us that are all flesh. This might be a mistake, but... Fine. I'll strive to stop him, and will do what I can to see that he lives. Thank you. Saravak can be redeemed, as could you, should you one day pursue the same path. For now, I shall speak of secrets to aid you. Duke Eltan may be saved, but Duke Entar's Silvershield has been killed outright. The murderers have acted with anonymity, but I know who and where they are. You must go to the Undercellar, return, if you have already been. There you will find Slythe and Kristen, two unsavory beings that revel in the violence Saravak allows them to commit. They are no more than animals in human guise, even by the standards of the company they keep. Kill them, and you shall know much of the plan. If you do not know where the Undercellar is located, then go to the sewers. You will find an entrance there. They are already dead. There is another. Atop the Iron Throne base is a woman whose... She wasn't even surprised by that. Whose influence is a poison in Saravak's soul. If she were removed, I know he would listen to reason, to my pleading. Sethandria is her name, and she holds much power in this matter. She seeks Saravak's favor as well, though she is content if he self-destructs, so long as she profits in the deed. I must go. You cannot know that I have helped you. Okay. So he looks visible.
Yep.
By temple shield.
Let's take these out. I know I like went past them a few times. monsters are about.
I need an ale.
In the form of men.
Why me?
Benji? Isn't he upstairs? Duke Eltan?
Alright.
I'm not sure who that is. We can't keep interacting with people. Where's the way up? The monster's about now. This is open. Someone's trying to get out of somewhere. I mean, that goes down. I thought it was upstairs. Or am I thinking of even the wrong building? Let's try going down here. No, this is not where he is.
Sure. All right.
Huh. That's the only thing. To find entrances and exits. Entrances and exits. It still doesn't show up when you hit tab. A rogue. Yeah, here are people looting things. And it's not us. This we can't even open. The cell door appears to have been tampered with. Might he be somewhere else? I don't think the door would be through any of these. Wait, is this... Ah! Very hard to see. Okay, good.
I don't want to talk.
Kent.
Go past it! Sure!
Rashad! Alright, let's get in place.
I need an ale.
I don't know who Kent is, but... he might join in this battle.
I don't... Alright!
They're called? As well as I can.
Cool! Ball plate and packing steel.
Yeah, we pushed
what
him.
You want? Here! How are things going?
Anyone through
Hurry.
Here?
Good job.
Just want to get surprised. Not sure if we were, like, not visible. Well, not visible. Say we were visible. I wonder if they would still show up as this, or just immediately attacking as red.
Go pester someone else.
Sure.
What is your thy Valkor's mighty blade?
She'll basically guard these two. Cheesy save.
I need an ale.
Greetings.
All right.
Rashad says, "Who are you? What are you doing here?" We're here to protect the Duke. Stupid primates. It was your last mistake to come here. Guards, let us see how your vaunted skills perform against one who was born an assassin. Primates, okay. So, it's doppelganger. Yeah.
I don't wanna talk.
Greater doppelganger.
Whatever they need.
Let's not hurt the Duke.
What?
I meant to have
fine.
Further away.
You point, I punch.
Go pester someone else.
I'm pointing there.
Hello?
Yes?
By temper shield!
Let's hope this doesn't reach our spellcasters.
What is it? Such menial tasks. What?
Every crime must be punished!
Kent says, "You there! Shh! Don't make too much noise! My name is Kent, and I want to talk to you." What is it you want? Kent, we're busy being attacked right now. I remember the bunch of you from when he... this is ridiculous. I remember the bunch of you from when we walked to work for Scar and Eltan. Well, since you've been gone, things have gone downhill. Eltan's taken ill, and he's resting in the room beside us. We're in this room. His healer, Rashad, keeps on saying there's nothing he can do, but I know better. He's no healer from what I've seen. Yeah, look at him now. Anyhow, it don't matter. I've decided to desert the Flaming Fist before things get too hairy. I don't want to lose my life over whatever power struggle is going on in the city. Let's see what he knows. Why don't you think Rashad's a healer? I mean, he looks so much like one, doesn't he? I followed him one night, all the way into the sewers. There he went into the undercellar. Why would a healer be found in a whorehouse? I don't know what he was doing there, but it wasn't good, whatever it was. I have to get going before my commander notices that I'm deserting. Perhaps we'll meet again. I suppose you can help us out. Okay then. Bye. Take care of that. The recent trouble has one of the former guards planning to desert the Flaming Fist. According to Kent, Eltan's healer, Rashad, frequents a brothel called the Undercellar. The place is so foul that the entrance lies to the city sewers. So funny, they... all these prompts to go to the Undercellar, we've already been there. A Moonbar gem. Have we seen this before? Moonbar is a pearly white, opaque gemstone, usually pale blue with green and gold modeling. Related in type to fire and black opals, it is only slightly more common. Duke Eltan.
Such menial tasks.
Okay. Can't talk to him? Have we seen these things?
Yes, a simple matter.
Alright, is there anything else we can do for him? We can actually cast that. Nope, okay. Alright. Well. Okay, you guys can go that way. Oh, yeah. It cast something on us. I didn't even see. Oh, Duke Eltan was silenced. The silence probably...
I need an owl.
Wore off. Yeah, it did. Did that thing even cast anything on us? Attacks, Minsk, morale failure. The doppelganger was silenced. I don't think it... Yeah, didn't really get to do much. It was outnumbered.
I don't want to talk.
Let's go downstairs and hope for the best. Tell them we saved Duke Eltan.
Sure. Why me?
Delos?
What do you need?
Greetings. Is there something I can help? Wait a moment. You're the ones wanted for murder.
I have a blade with your name on it.
Well, that was stupid.
Go pester someone else.
Could I wish my ear? D'accord.
I need... All right.
We'll be going now.
Sorry, friend. But you've got a date.
Got something coming, pal.
Oh, I missed him. Oh, there's a whole bunch now.